Hey guys, this is Uttam Singh from Solo Pivot Power. Thanks for tuning in. So this video is about the effect of heat on the power production of solar panels. And being the middle of summer in Central Texas kind of gives me the perfect platform to not only talk about the theory of it, but also to conduct some real world experiments and see as the temperature rises, what happens to power production of portable solar panels. So what I'm gonna do is work with Jackery Solar Saga 100 watt panels, since they're kind of considered the best of class in that category. And let's see how they actually fare.
So to start with, I tested the power production from four of the Jackery panels, and then I selected the two best performing panels. For our test setup, we'll be using two Jackery 1000 watt hour power stations. They're charged to the same level, 36%. And our prototype multipurpose tripod stand with dual carriage and mechanical tracker. Now, we will not be using tracking for this test, but the tripod pan and tilt functions will allow us to have the same solar orientation for both panels. We'll be releasing more details on the production models in the near future. And before mounting the panels in the sun, a temperature check shows that both the panels are about 87 degrees Fahrenheit, or about 30 degrees Celsius. Okay, so here we have each solar panel is connected to a separate power station. And as the panels warm up, the MPPT controller will make adjustments to extract the most optimal power. Right now, we can see on the left side, we're getting about 80 watts. And on the right side, we're getting about 85 watts. And the solar panels themselves have roughly the same solar orientation. And a temperature check at the start of the test shows that the panel on the right side is running at about 104 degrees Fahrenheit. And on the left side, it's about 108. Okay, now that the panels have been out in the sun for about 5 minutes, let's take a temperature check again. And now we see that the panels are running much warmer, 125 for the right panel and about 126, 127 for the left panel. And as the panels warm up, we can see a drop in power production. On the right side, it was producing 85 and now it's down to 67. And on the left side was at about 80, and it's holding pretty steady at about 76, 77. Okay, after about 15 minutes, we can see that the power generation has dropped further. It's below 75 on the left one and below 60 on the right one. So as the panels are getting warmer, the power is going down. Let's take another temperature check. It was at 125 and it's now at about 140 on both the panels. Okay, so now I've put the panels down. To cool them down, I have brought them in shade, and I'll wait till they drop below 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and then we'll restart the test and also talk about the correlation between temperature and power generation from these panels. And on our restart, we can see that both panels start off by producing about 80 watts. So both left and right are producing roughly 80, 81 watts of power. And a quick check on temperature shows that, you know, they're starting to warm up again and they're at about 117 right now. So while we have a time lapse of the power test running in the background, let's talk about the four factors that are in play here. Okay, so first we have to consider how are these panels rated, like 100 watts, 200 watts, etc. Obviously, these panels are designed with intended power rating by having multiple solar cells connected in a specific configuration. However, the qualification is performed in a controlled lab environment. The three predefined things, also called standard test conditions or STC, are sunlight exposure or irradiance at 1000 watts per meter square, the solar cell temperature, not ambient, at 25 degrees Celsius or 77 degrees Fahrenheit, and air mass of 1.5 atmosphere. Think of this as sun being at 30 degree angle, hence sunlight is passing through 1.5 times the atmosphere. Next, let's look at a semiconductor-related phenomena that dictates the panel VI power curve. As the temperature rises, the voltage in a solar cell drops, while the current actually slightly increases. This results in a drop in the power output of a solar cell, as power equals voltage times current. Most panel makers also publish a temperature coefficient for their panel models. This number represents the decrease in power, expressed in percentage terms, for every degree increase in temperature. The base temperature is as defined in SDC, which is 25 degrees Celsius or 77 degrees Fahrenheit. In theory, there is supposed to be an increase in power production when it's cooler than SDC temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. Jacquery has published a temperature coefficient of negative 0.29% per degree Celsius. And final major factor is quality of construction. The material used, example aluminum versus copper wires, connectivity, soldering, and general workmanship. To summarize observed versus expected results, the panel on left works exactly to the spec. There is a nominal decline in power generation with rise in temperature. However, the panel on the right shows a large variance. The power generation does not comply with Jacquery's published specification. Unfortunately for me, this was the case for 3 out of 4 Jacquery panels. And finally, to eliminate the possibility of the MPPT in the power station playing a part in the inferior performance of the right panel, I switched the panel connections. The observed power generation is seen to be specific to the panel and not related to the power stations. In the coming days, I'll conduct a similar test with a different brand. For now, thank you for tuning in, and you can find more details about our products in the description.